Good afternoon. I'm meteorologist Kellyanne Chickalise. An impact weather day as we're now tracking the likelihood for strong to severe storms. The likelihood here that some of these storms that develop later this afternoon and into this evening could produce damaging wind and even a chance of tornadoes, localized flooding. Unfortunately, this is the type of pattern where we cannot pinpoint which locations will see the localized flooding issue, but it is a concern where some spots could see up to 3 inches, and it's something we'll be pinpointing once the storms start firing off. Now, that risk of flash flooding and really any sort of severe weather is strongest as you move northwest of Boston. So pretty much the entire area of red here is where we're most concerned for those stronger storms to develop today. And while the time frame is 1 to 10, I do want to mention that that shift in timing toward Boston is really in the late afternoon into the evening. So we do get a good chunk of our early afternoon before storms become more of an issue. In fact, right now, it is dry out there. We're seeing some signs of brightening. Take a look at this hole in the cloud deck right over Rhode Island, moving into southern Worcester County and also starting to push through Metro West. This is trying to work its way eastward. Any sort of brightening that we see here today will help to destabilize our atmosphere. We have more signs of that brightening moving out into western Massachusetts and New York, and that will also be shifting eastward. That's as a warm front has moved its way through our area. Things are heating up. We're getting more humid. And with some of that brightening, these are all the factors that really help to contribute to a severe weather threat. We have a cold front that's moving in from the west, moving into this very unstable atmosphere. So this is also an ingredient that will help to ignite this storm threat. Take a look at the humidity. Dew point temperatures climbing through the 70s at this moment, so it is turning to tropical levels of humidity, especially as you move south and west through much of Connecticut and into portions of Norwood. We expect this kind of humidity will help to fuel these storms that continue to develop. We are in the upper 70s to low 80s right now. It will get hot this afternoon. We're making a run toward the upper 80s today, with the exception of the South Coast, Cape and Islands. The south wind that's transporting in the heat will be a wind off the ocean in these locations. That's why 70s are going to be more widespread down there. It's a gusty south wind, wind gusts near 30 miles per hour, and that's ahead of the actual thunderstorms producing wind within themselves. That storm threat for Boston, you can see it's really toward the late afternoon into this evening, but it's earlier for areas northwest. So let's get through the timeline so we can pinpoint when you can expect these storms moving toward you. We move toward about 2 o'clock today, and we see storms likely starting to develop just to our northwest, getting closer to home as we travel into late afternoon, early evening. 4 or 5 o'clock, storms start firing off here locally and shifting eastward. Notice how more widespread we're starting to see the storms here on our computer models as we stretch toward the 7 o'clock hour. And any of these individual cells that you're seeing here being depicted could bring that chance for some small rotation, but also that chance for that damaging wind potential, especially with some of these longer lines here that we're seeing up to the north that could really bring some widespread wind damage. We move toward 10 o'clock this evening. I do think we'll still have a few storms to track, but they lose some punch in the overnight, and so we transition from a severe weather threat to more in the way of just a shower threat overnight, and that will start to shift its way southward into your Monday. A spot shower too can't be ruled out for Monday afternoon, but overall, we are seeing improvements.